This video was made in collaboration with the Bleach Wiki. For more information, check out the link in the description. The Life of Sōsuke Aizen, Bleach. Sōsuke Aizen is the former captain of the 5th Division in the Gotei 13. He later leaves Soul Society with his followers, Gin Ichimaru and Kaname Tōsen. His lieutenant was Momo Hinamori. He formerly served as the lieutenant of the 5th Division under Shinji Hirako. After waging war against Soul Society with an army of Arrancar, Aizen was defeated by Ichigo Kurosaki and sealed away by Kisuke Urahara, and then imprisoned for his crimes. Welcome to the Amagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Sōsuke Aizen. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. The Amagi's reach stretches beyond just this channel, so if you're a fan of us, please consider subscribing to our other channels and following us on all of our social media accounts. Help us reach our goal of passing 100,000 followers on all of our accounts by the end of the year. And with that out of the way, let's get into the video. Background. At an unknown point in the past, Aizen became part of the 5th Division under Captain Shinji Hirako. He invested himself in the research and creation of the Hogyoku even before Kisuke Urahara. To this end, he sacrificed hundreds of Shinigami and hundreds of Rukongai citizens who bore Shinigami talents to his own Hogyoku. But he was not satisfied with this. At one point, a young Gin Ichimaru watched Aizen meet with three other Shinigami who were kneeling before him. One of the Shinigami handed Aizen the Hogyoku, prompting Aizen to put the orb in a glass and hand it back to the Shinigami. Aizen and his subordinates left an unconscious Rangiku Matsumoto a short distance away. Aizen eventually caught Shinji's attention and was promoted to a lieutenant in order for Shinji to watch over him closely, but Shinji's action only helped further the realization of his plans. 110 years ago, Aizen made his way to the 5th Division living quarters of his captain. He and Shinji discussed style and trends before they made their way to the promotion ceremony being held at the 1st Division headquarters. As they got there, he witnessed 12th Division Lieutenant Hiyori Sarugaki attack his captain, and watched as the two got into a childish argument. He followed behind while the other captains congregated and had a brief discussion on the status of the Gotei 13. Overhearing 8th Division Captain Shunsui Kyoraku mention that the previous captain of the 12th Division was promoted, Aizen interrupted and asked Shunsui what he meant by this. When Aizen initially conjectured that the promotion was to Central 46, Shunsui explained it had nothing to do with the Central 46 and revealed the previous 12th Division Captain Kiryu Hikifune had been accepted into the Royal Guard, shocking Aizen. The following night, after Urahara's appointment as the new captain of the 12th Division, Shinji had a short talk with him about his new role as captain. While leaving, Shinji revealed Aizen, who had been concealed behind camouflage. Complimenting his captain, Aizen asked Shinji when he sensed him there. Stating he had known ever since Aizen was in his mother's womb, Shinji ordered Aizen to follow. Noting his disapproval, Aizen commented on how scary a person Shinji was, prompting Shinji to say that Aizen was the scary one. The next night, Aizen saw Gin killing the third seat of their division. Informing Gin he was impressed by his skill, Aizen asked him how he found the fight, prompting Gin to state he found it pathetic. 9 years later, Shinji and Aizen were walking around the Seirete when they came across Urahara, Hiyori, and 12th Division 3rd seat, Mayuri Kurosuchi. While Shinji once again engaged in a childish fight and argument with Hiyori, Aizen asked Urahara if he had heard the news. When Urahara told Aizen he had not, Shinji told Urahara about the series of strange deaths which had taken place in Rukongai and informed him the 9th Division had been sent to handle the investigation. With the disappearance of the 9th Division, Captain Commander Genryusai Chigakuni Yamamoto called an emergency meeting and assembled a team to investigate. After coming into contact with Hollowfield 9th Division members, the investigation team was dispatched by an unseen assailant. It was later revealed 9th Division 5th seat Kaname Tōsen was behind the betrayal of the 9th Division. When an injured Shinji asked Tōsen why he betrayed his captain, he was surprised to be answered by Aizen, who stated Tōsen did not betray anyone and faithfully followed his orders. When Shinji admitted he wasn't as surprised as he seemed to be, Aizen asked Shinji if he suspected him and stated that he had expected this much from his captain. Explaining how he had known something was dangerous about Aizen and he couldn't be trusted, Shinji said he chose Aizen to be his lieutenant so he could keep an eye on him, prompting Aizen to state that he was grateful because Shinji didn't suspect a thing due to his deep-seated doubts. When Shinji said he already made it known he had suspected him, Aizen reveals Shinji didn't realize Aizen wasn't the one walking behind him for the past month. Explaining the power of his Zanpakuto, Kyoka Suigetsu, Aizen informed Shinji he would have been able to see through Aizen's deception by picking up on subtle differences between Aizen himself and Aizen's double if he was as close to Aizen as other captains were to their lieutenants. But it was his lack of trust which kept them from getting close and allowed Aizen to fool Shinji, stating he could have always refused to be Shinji's lieutenant. Aizen revealed he decided against this action because his captain's skepticism made the position ideal to carry out his plans. Aizen thanked Shinji for helping him and raised his blade overhead in preparation to cut Shinji down, only to be attacked by Urahara, who cut Aizen's lieutenant badge off. Aizen and Urahara had a brief discussion about what was transpiring. Aizen revealed himself to be behind the disappearances in the Rukongai. Leaving the scene of the crime with Gin and Tōsen, Aizen said that there was nothing more to do there. When Tessai fired Hado No. 88, Hideo Gekzoku Shinten Raiho at them, Aizen blocked it with Bakudo No. 81 Danku, allowing them to escape. At some point after the Holification incident, Aizen became captain of the 5th Division and eventually made Gin his lieutenant. Continuing to experiment on hollows to transform them into Shinigami, Aizen created hollows which were close to Shinigami, such as Metastasia and Menos, capable of concealing the Reiatsu. While testing out this breed of Menos, Aizen and Gin saved the then first year academy students Momo Hinamori, Izuru Kira, and Renji Abarai from them. With his interest piqued by them, Aizen realized their potential and took them all into his division. At some point during their captaincy, Aizen, Gin, and Tōsen secretly visited Barragán Luisenban, king of Huecomundo and lord of Las Noches. He and Barragán engaged in light conversation, with Aizen asking Barragán if he was happy in his position and if he would join him in a new world where he would be granted more power. Barragán dismissed this notion and stated there was no power higher than his. Releasing his shikai, Aizen showed Barragán the decimation of his army, thus subjugating him in turn. This created great enmity between Aizen and Barragán, who promised to see Aizen's destruction for all eternity. Soon after this, Aizen and his two comrades watched the fight between Isshin and one of their holo creations on a monitor, with Aizen wondering why Isshin was present at Naruki City. When Tōsen stated Isshin didn't report he was going, and Gin said this could cause them immense trouble, Aizen, intrigued by this interesting turn of events, referred to Isshin's arrival as an unexpected harvest and asked if it was possible for him to watch the battle at a closer distance. Later, when he arrives at the scene of the battle with Gin and Tōsen, commenting on the quality of Urahara's cloak and how simply kneading Kido into it will let the wearer blend into the air, Aizen prepared to leave, stating that Isshin would not be able to use Bankai in his current state and that the hollow experiment was a failure if a captain couldn't take it out using only their shikai. After Tōsen expressed his desire to call the sample white because this was their first experiment based on a Shinigami soul, Aizen said it was ironic to call the hollow white because of its inner whiteness while its outside was completely encased in black. After observing the fight for a time, Aizen and his cohorts noticed the involvement of a Quincy in the fight, which surprised the three of them. When Tōsen decided to eliminate her, Aizen stopped him from killing her and eagerly stated that they should see what happens next. Aizen became aware of the existence of Ichigo Kurosaki when he was born. Understanding the significance of his birth, Aizen decided to aid Ichigo's development for his plans. To this end, he had Rikia Kuchiki stationed in Karakura Town. Aizen also put into place obstacles which would force Ichigo to grow stronger, including the hollow which attacked his family, and the Menos Grande which appeared when Uryo Ishida used the hollow bait. Soul Society Arc. When Rukia is brought back to Soul Society with the Hogyoku concealing within her body, Aizen manipulates everyone into an elaborate conspiracy by killing all of the members of Central 46 and beginning to move Rukia's execution date up. He begins to plant suspicion within Soul Society, initially speaking of the possibility of a conspiracy with 6th Division Lieutenant Renji Abarai, and tries to use Gin Ichimaru's intrusion in repelling Ichigo Kurosaki and the Ryoka to orchestrate suspicion among the gathered captains, particularly 10th Division Captain Toshiro Hitsugaya, who witnesses a conversation between the two personally. Later, Aizen uses his Zanpakuto's ability to trick everyone into believing he had been killed, and has Gin lead everyone to believe that Gin himself is the murderer. Aizen sets up his lieutenant, Momo Hinamori, to believe he was killed by Hitsugaya, her childhood friend, to get her out of the way. Because of the nature of Rukia's sentence and execution method, the Gotei 13 splits into factions and the captains begin to fight amongst themselves. During the turmoil, Gin executes the overt aspects of the plan, which begins to be revealed when 4th Division Captain Retsu Unohana begins to suspect there's something wrong with Aizen's supposedly dead body. Using a camera fly, Aizen watches a hollowfied Ichigo fighting 6th Division Captain Byakuya Kuchiki from the Shinigami Research and Development Institute. At this moment, Gin approaches Aizen and wonders if Ichigo has already undergone hollowification. When Ichigo regains control over his body, Gin becomes disappointed, but Aizen tells them there's nothing to worry about. Stating that everything is going according to plan, Aizen says it all begins now. Aizen reveals himself by nearly killing his lieutenant and defeating Hitsugaya. Commenting on how nice it is to see ice at this time of year, Aizen is stopped by Unohana, who's figured out something's wrong with his corpse doll, only for Aizen to bring out his corpse doll and disclose it to Unohana and her lieutenant, Isane Kotetsu, the true abilities of his Zanpakuto. This allows Unohana to deduce the ritual for being affected by the hypnosis, after which Aizen reveals Kaname Tōsen has always been his subordinate because he can't see. Aizen has Gin bring the two of them to Sōkyoku Hill, where Tōsen had brought Renji and Rukia to him. When Aizen asks Renji to put Rukia down, Renji refuses. Commenting on Renji's stubbornness, Aizen says that it's acceptable if Renji wishes to hold on to Rukia, but he'll have to leave the arms he's holding her with behind. Drawing his sword, Aizen attacks Renji, but Renji is able to draw his sword in time to dodge Aizen's attack, leaving only his right arm damaged. Applauding his ability to dodge, Aizen expresses happiness with the improvements in Renji's skill because he was one of Aizen's subordinates, telling Renji he doesn't want things to be harder because while he finds it difficult to hold back his strength, Aizen states he finds it unbearable for a subordinate to die. Challenging this assertion, Renji asks Aizen why he killed Momo. When Aizen states it was an act of compassion because he has trained Momo so she could not live without him, Renji says Aizen is not the captain he knew, prompting Aizen to state he was the same man, but neither Renji nor anyone else had realized what he was. When Renji attacks Aizen with a shikai, Aizen blocks it with his bare hand and easily cuts the segments of the blade apart while also cutting up Renji. When Renji refuses to give up Rukia, Aizen prepares to kill him only to be stopped by Ichigo. Ichigo teams up with Renji even after using Renji's strongest attack with his shikai to create an opening for Ichigo, the attack fails, displaying his power by blocking Ichigo's blade with a single finger and nearly cutting him in half. Aizen cuts down Renji and approaches Rukia. Beginning to drag Rukia off, Aizen explains his plans to the critically injured but still conscious Ichigo, only for 7th Division Captain Sajin Komamura to appear and attack him. Critically injuring Komamura with Hado No. 90, Kuro Hitsugi, Aizen removes the Hogyoku from Rukia's body using information obtained by Kisuke Urahara's research hidden in the chambers of Central 46. Surprised the procedure didn't kill Rukia and having no further use for her, Aizen orders Gin to kill Rukia as he prepares to leave, only for 6th Division Captain Byakuya Kuchiki to save Rukia by taking the blow himself. Turning around, Aizen prepares to draw his Zanpakuto in order to finish Rukia himself, but is stopped by Yoruichi Shihoen. When he's threatened with death from the 2nd Division Captain Zanpakuto if he moves, Aizen calls Yoruichi a nostalgic face and notes how not even Yoruichi and Soifon will be able to come after him while fighting the hypnotized gatekeepers. As Kukoku Shiba and Jidanbo Ikanzaka arrive to assist them, Gin is restrained by 10th Division Lieutenant Rangiku Matsumoto and apologizes for being unable to help Aizen. As they're surrounded by every captain and lieutenant of the Gotei 13 still capable of moving, Aizen smiles and says it's time. Realizing something's wrong, Yoruichi runs away and tells Soifong to get away. When Aizen, Gin, and Tōsen are bathed in light, Captain Commander Genryusai Shigekuni Yamamoto calls the others off and reveals Aizen, Tōsen, and Gin became completely untouchable the moment they were covered in this light, a separate world created by Menos Grande when rescuing one of their own, which transports them to Wekomundo. While leaving, Aizen removes his glasses and changes his hairstyle by combing a hand through it. As his glasses evaporate into dust, Aizen announces his goal to stand atop of the world in the heavens and take the place of the absent gods, something no one has ever done before. Before finally ascending into the portal created by the Menos' arrival, he bids farewell to all of the Shinigami present and tells Ichigo he was very interesting for a human. Arrancar Arc. From there, Aizen changes his clothing style to resemble the Arrancar and begins to create several Arrancar. At some point, he finds Coyote Stark and Lilynet Gingerbuck and is impressed by the mountain of dead hollows nearby. When Aizen asks Stark if the hollows were killed by him, Stark tells him the hollows just died. When Aizen makes an offer to Stark to join him as an ally, Stark believes Aizen to be strong and agrees to join him. Later, Aizen sends Ulquiorra Seafer and Yami to find Ichigo and report on his progress. They almost kill Tatsuki Irasawa, Yasutora Sado, and Orihime Inoue, and Yami manages to kill a large amount of people in the park. After the mission's completed, Ukiyora and Yami head to a meeting consisting of Aizen and 20 other Arrancar, including fellow Espada members Grimjao Jaeger Yakes and Tyr Hadibel. Ukiyora uses Solida Vista to show what he's seen to the others and Aizen. After Grimjao and Shaolong Kofang question Ukiyora and Yami on why they just didn't kill them as ordered, Aizen states he's impressed with Ukiyora's work. Later, after examining Orihime's powers, Aizen decides to initiate another invasion on Karakura Town, letting Ukiyora pick the members of the invasion force, though Aizen personally sends Grimjao as well. Ukiyora, Grimjao, Yami, Lupi Entenor, and Wonder Ray's Margella go to invade Karakura Town to capture Orihime. Ukiyora succeeds in forcing Orihime to join Aizen's side and brings her to Las Noches, where he has her display her power by restoring Grimjao's amputated left arm and reveals to the Arrancar present how Orihime's powers are rejection, meaning she can reject anything which has happened. Wakamundo Arc. Calling the Espada to a meeting, Aizen invites them to have some tea. As they're drinking their tea, Aizen reveals to them the presence of Ichigo, Uryu, and Sado. When the Espada begin to dismiss their group as not dangerous, Aizen warns them to not underestimate the trio and reveals their exploits in Soul Society. When Aizen identifies Orihime as the missing member of their group and states they've come to rescue her, Grimjao begins to leave and states he's going to eradicate the threat in Aizen's name. Stopping him, Aizen resorts to intimidating Grimjao with his Reiatsu when the latter hesitates to back down. As Grimjao is brought to his knees by Aizen's immense Reiatsu, Aizen tells the other Espada to return to their palaces and wait patiently. Telling them not to be overconfident, Aizen says they don't need to be afraid, because no one can defeat them as long as they're with him. At one point, Aizen has Orihime brought to his room by Loli Ivern and Menoli Malia. After sending the two Arrancar away, Aizen shows Orihime the Hogyoku. Asking Orihime to interpret him, showing her the Hogyoku as a sign of his trust in her, Aizen asks Orihime to use Soten Kishun to undo some minor damage which has occurred to the Hogyoku from being repeatedly awakened. Following the arrival of Ichigo and company at Las Noches, Aizen is informed of Dordoni Alessandro del Socasio's death by a messenger. Unsurprised by Dordoni's demise, Aizen expresses surprise at Ichigo struggling against him. Cornering the messenger by catching him in a lie of omission, Aizen demands to know who sent the Exequias after Dordoni. When the messenger doesn't answer, Zayalo Poro Granz intervenes and reveals he's the one who did so before begging Aizen's forgiveness, which Aizen grants him. As Zayalo Poro turns to leave, Aizen tells him to make his reports more thorough next time, shocking him before asking him if the Reiatsu record he obtained from Dordoni will aid in his research. Confirming this, Zayalo Poro leaves. Following his departure, Gin, who had been present with Aizen the entire time, asks Aizen if he's enjoying himself even though his subordinates are losing, prompting Aizen to confess the emotion he's feeling at the moment is akin to enjoyment. And I totally apologize if I butcher all of these names! After Eronero, Zayalo Poro, Zomari, Grimjao, and Noitra Gilga are defeated by Ichigo, his friends, and the invading Shinigami captains, Aizen has Coyote Stark bring Orihime to him. Telling Orihime to smile and wait where she is while they go and destroy Karakura Town, Aizen has Tōsen use Bakudo No. 77, Tente Kura. Using this, Aizen reveals his true motivation behind the capture of Orihime to Ichigo and the others. By kidnapping Orihime, he inspired Ichigo and his friends to attempt a rescue, thereby depriving Soul Society of a valuable military asset. And when four captains assisted in her rescue, adding to the three which had already defected, Soul Society was left at half its regular strength. So he and his forces are now ready to attack, leaving with Gin, Tōsen, Tyr Haribel, Barragan, Stark, and their fraction to invade Karakura Town. Aizen leaves Las Noches in the hands of Ukiyora. Fake Karakura Town Arc. Leaving to destroy Karakura Town, Aizen seals the portals Ichigo and the others used to access Wakamundo, effectively stranding them there until his return, and leaves Ukiyora in charge of Las Noches. When Soul Society substitutes the town for an abandoned duplicate, Aizen muses on how he'll have to travel to Soul Society to destroy the real town after he and his forces defeat the remaining captains. Before his group is able to take action, Aizen's trapped within Yamamoto's Jokaku Enjo with Gin and Tōsen and is unable to fight. Claiming such action would be unnecessary, Aizen states the power of his Espada alone will be enough to defeat the Gotei 13. When Momo arrives in the fake Karakura Town to assist Rengiku Matsumoto, Aizen has a somewhat intrigued look in his eyes upon sensing his former lieutenant, whom he assumed he killed, is alive. When Yin asks if anything's wrong, Aizen says Momo's presence will not make any difference. Arriving in the fake Karakura town alongside Wonder Weiss, Hulier extinguishes Jokaku Enjo with its breath. Stating the smell of death is splendid, Aizen walks free with his two comrades and says the smell fits the occasion. As everyone is alerted in Aizen's presence, 3rd Division Lieutenant Izuru Kira fears Soul Society may have lost. After a short battle against a group of Gileans, Shinji Hirako confronts Aizen. Attempting to slash at Aizen, Shinji is stopped by Tōsen as Aizen looks on. As the battle continues, Barrigan comes close to his death and throws his blade at Aizen in a desperate attempt to kill the person responsible for Barrigan losing his position as King of Wakamundo, only for Barrigan's Respera to destroy the axe before it can even reach Aizen, who looks away. As both Stark and Harabell notice this, Stark notes Aizen has nothing to say at Barrigan's passing. Observing Stark's defeat as he falls to the ground, Aizen subsequently takes notice of the fight between Tyr Harabell and Hiyori Sarugaki, Lisa Yadomaru, and Toshiro Hitsugaya. Stopping the fight between Gin and Shinji, Aizen tells Gin this is enough and states it's time to end this fight. Using Shunpo, Aizen appears near Harabell's battle and slashes her straight across her torso with his Zanpakuto, seriously wounding her. As Harabell expresses surprise, Aizen tells her it appears she's not strong enough to fight for him before telling Gin and Tōsen it's time to go. As Aizen laments to Harabell how he alone is more powerful than all of the Espada he went through so much trouble to gather, an enraged Harabell impales him with her sword. As Aizen states dealing with her is such a pain, a surprised Harabell realizes she attacked an illusion and has been stabbed in her left shoulder by Aizen. Telling Harabell he will never let her raise her sword to him again, Aizen withdraws his sword. As Harabell falls to the city below, Aizen tells everyone to come at him. When Shinji warns the other visor not to approach Aizen too quickly, Aizen says they already died 100 years ago, so they have nothing to fear. Charging Aizen, an enraged Hiyori is bifurcated by Gin. As Aizen says he will unsheath his sword especially for him, Shinji approaches his former lieutenant to engage him in battle. When Shinji tells the others to wait for Ichigo to arrive, Aizen asks Shinji why he would put his faith in Ichigo. When Shinji tells Aizen he doesn't expect him to understand because he doesn't even trust his own followers, Aizen says only the weak rely on others. When Shinji questions how he can say this with all the followers he has, for he's sure Aizen has asked him to trust him, Aizen states he's wrong because he never asked them to trust him at all, revealing he told them to come with him, but he's never told them to trust him, and has told them to not trust anyone, including himself. Aizen further explains how everyone wishes to believe in something bigger than themselves, and he'll become the god everyone's forced to put their faith in. Commenting on Aizen drawing his blade, Shinji asks Aizen if he's scared. When Aizen remains silent, Shinji says there's no point in ignoring him, because he still has to be uneasy no matter how strong he is. Telling Aizen he's wrong if he believes Kyoka Suigetsu is the only Zanpakuto with the ability to control other people's senses, Shinji releases his Zanpakuto, Sakanade. The release of Shinji's Shikai prompts Aizen to note it's an interesting shape for a katana. As the ability of Sakanade takes effect and reverses the world around them, Shinji attacks and manages to cut Aizen. After another attempt, Aizen figures out the ability and cuts Shinji before stating the ability is child's play. Moments later, he looks down as Komamura yells up at him. As the sky begins to crack, Ichigo breaks through behind Aizen. As Ichigo's Getsuka Tensho hits a barrier which Aizen had created, Aizen taunts Ichigo, who attacks again. Dodging, Aizen continues his taunts. When Ichigo begins to waver, Komamura appears beside him and tells Ichigo not to be disheartened, for provoking his opponents is Aizen's forte. He and the other Shinigami and Visored prepare to help Ichigo fight Aizen while avoiding witnessing the release of his Shikai. When Hitsugaya starts to attack, Aizen mocks this. Becoming angry, Hitsugaya releases his Bankai. Attacked by Hitsugaya, Aizen dodges every attack from him. As Aizen prepares to attack, Komamura and Love Aikawa attack him, but Aizen stops them. When Komamura activates his Bankai, Kokuju Tengen Myo, Aizen slices through it, cutting off Komamura's arm. As Aizen attacks Komamura once more, Rojuro Otoribashi tries to attack Aizen, only for Aizen to pull Rose towards him and slash him, sending Rose falling to the ground. Defeating the remaining Visored, Aizen calls them Pseudo Arrancar. Moving in front of Aizen, Sufon mocks him and creates several clones of herself with Shunpo. As the clones attack, Hitsugaya encases Aizen in ice as 8th Division Captain Shunsui Kyoraku emerges from the shadow to attack him. As Hitsugaya attacks him, Aizen glances at him and notes Hitsugaya doesn't plan ahead due to his young age. Noticing Shinji holding Sakanade, Aizen realizes it's too late to react because he's in the inverted world as Hitsugaya impales him. Being the only one who hasn't yet seen Aizen Shikai, Ichigo shouts at the captains, causing them to realize Aizen used Kyoka Suigetsu and switch places with Momo. Having been lying down next to Izuru and 7th Division Lieutenant Tetsuzaimon Iba, Aizen gets up and walks away after his illusion is revealed. Believing it's Momo who's walking away, Izuru and Iba try to follow him but are cut down. When Shinji angrily asks Aizen when he cast the illusion, Aizen asks them when they began thinking he was not using Kyoka Suigetsu. Overcome with anger at being fooled by Aizen into attacking Momo, Hitsugaya charges at Aizen while Shunsui warns him to wait. Telling them they're all completely open, Aizen cuts down Hitsugaya, Shunsui, Soifon, and Shinji. As Aizen defeats the last of its attackers, Yamamoto draws his attention with a huge pillar of fire. Stating Yamamoto's too late and the Gotei 13 will crumble with his defeat, Aizen taunts Yamamoto before stabbing him. Pulling Aizen in, Yamamoto says he can tell it's not an illusion. Activating Ennetsu Jigoku, Yamamoto states everything caught within it will burn. Appearing behind Yamamoto in his Resurrection Extinguir, Wonder Weiss sends Yamamoto crashing to the ground below as Aizen reveals Wonder Weiss was made for the sole purpose of stopping Yamamoto's abilities. Employing his hand-to-hand combat skills, Yamamoto defeats Wonder Weiss. When Aizen says Yamamoto's flames were all stored within Wonder Weiss, Yamamoto attempts to contain them as Wonder Weiss's body explodes. Afterwards, as Aizen approaches, a battered Yamamoto uses Hado No. 96, Ito Kaso. Pouncing on Aizen, Ichigo sends him crashing through a nearby building. As the wound he sustained from the attack closes up, Aizen reveals he's placed the Hogyoku, which instinctively heals its master, in his chest. Complimenting Ichigo's Reiatsu, Aizen states Ichigo has grown as he'd planned, surprising Ichigo. Listing various important occurrences in Ichigo's development, Aizen claims they all happened as he desired. When Aizen explains how he found Ichigo to be the perfect subject for his research, Ichigo says Aizen must be lying because of what he said in Soul Society. Revealing he was lying back then, Aizen begins to say why he thought Ichigo would be perfect, but is interrupted by the arrival of Ishin. When Ishin moves Ichigo away, Aizen notes this was a smart move. When Aizen asks Gin how long he's been watching, Gin states he didn't see an opportunity to help. Attacking Aizen, Ishin sends him crashing through multiple buildings. As their battle continues, Ishin notes Aizen's tiring, prompting Aizen to reveal he's reached the limit of his Shinigami self and the Hogyoku has begun to understand his desires. Saying the Hogyoku possesses a will of its own and he only became aware of this after becoming its master, Aizen reveals the true power of the Hogyoku is not removing the boundaries between Shinigami and Hollow, but capturing and materializing the hearts around it. Claiming it's brought about the events surrounding Ichigo, Rukia, and Urahara, Aizen states Urahara misunderstood the nature of the Hogyoku because the breakdown of the barrier between Shinigami and Hollow was his own desire. Claiming Ichigo, Sado, and Orihime all got their powers from the Hogyoku, Aizen explains more about it before being interrupted by Gin, knocking Ichigo into a nearby building. As Ichigo talks to Ishin, Gin asks Aizen if he interrupted his speech. As Aizen says he had reached the end of his speech, his body is enveloped by the Hogyoku. Stating the Hogyoku deserves its name, Aizen is interrupted when he's shot from behind by Urahara, whom he welcomes onto the battlefield. After Urahara says it's been a long time since they last met, the two banter about Aizen's fusion with the Hogyoku. Stating it's not a fusion, Aizen claims he's subjugated the Hogyoku, which Urahara had failed to master. Glaring down at Aizen, Urahara admits it's true he was unable to master it in the past. Questioning his statement, Aizen says he must be unable to admit defeat. Retracting the question, Aizen impales Urahara and tells him he's already lost the chance to command the Hogyoku. As Urahara's body bursts, Urahara appears and uses Bakudo's number 61, Riku Jokoro. Revealing he saw the portable Gigai trick on Yami's report, Aizen admits he let his guard down, for he never thought Urahara would use such a petty trick, and asks Urahara what he'll do after constricting him. Asking Aizen why he believes Urahara would only use the level of Bakudo, Urahara uses Bakudo number 63, Sajo Sabaku, and Bakudo number 73, Kuyoshibari. When Urahara begins chanting an incantation, Aizen asks him if he believes Aizen will allow him to use his Kido. Stating it's too late to stop it, Urahara fires Hado number 91, Senju Koten Taiho. After the smoke explosion dissipates, Urahara notes Aizen has let down his guard because of his newfound power. Confirming this, Aizen appears behind Urahara and attacks him. When Aizen notes the Hogyoku has made him invincible and he has no need to dodge a level 90 Kido, Urahara says he was talking about how Aizen would never have come into physical contact with him twice without a plan. Trapped by spiritual energy cuffs at his wrist, Aizen stares in shock. As Urahara explains the nature of the seal, Aizen is enveloped in a pillar of light. As the smoke clears, Aizen appears behind Urahara in a new form and states this would have worked if he had not subjugated the Hogyoku. As Aizen says, the Hogyoku is beyond Urahara's comprehension and this battle is a waste, Urahara unsheaths his Sanpakuto. As Isshin comes from behind, he and Urahara restrict Aizen with chains. Expressing confusion, Aizen demands to know what's going on as Yoruichi Shihoin attacks him from above. Smashing into his back with great force, Yoruichi pummels Aizen into the ground. As Urahara tells Yoruichi to move away, Aizen recovers and destroys the armor on Yoruichi's left leg. Emerging from the rubble with his new form, Aizen proclaims he will destroy all of their attacks. Noting Yoruichi's armor must be special for her to survive his attack, Aizen states he plans on destroying this. Having shattered more of Yoruichi's armor, Aizen watches as Yoruichi and Urahara bicker again. Asking Aizen why he's staring at him, Urahara says Aizen's showing interest again. When Aizen reveals he finds Urahara interesting because he's the only one in Soul Society who exceeds his intellect, Urahara attacks Aizen, but Aizen blocks it and Yoruichi's sneak attack. As Aizen's about to counter her, Yoruichi activates Shunko and knocks Aizen to the ground, but her next attack is blocked. Intervening, Urahara binds him with Shibari, Benihime, and uses Hiyasobi Benihime Juzu Tsunagi, creating a massive explosion. Afterwards, Isshin attacks Aizen with Getsuga Tensho. Emerging from Isshin's attack with a large crack down his new form's face, Aizen defeats Isshin, Urahara, and Yoruichi and gathers Gin as he heads off towards Soul Society. Arriving at the Dongai with Gin, Aizen notices the approaching Kototsu. Destroying it, Aizen asks Gin what he's afraid of and states reasons only exist for those who can't live without it. As they arrive, Aizen notices they're not in Karakura Town because he destroyed the Kototsu. As they walk, they come into contact with a man who turns to dust upon getting close to Aizen due to his spiritual power. When Aizen and Gin approach, Tatsuki and Keigo Asano are able to withstand his power. When Keigo runs, Aizen says they'll start with Tatsuki. When Don Kononji hits him with a blast of energy, Aizen emerges from the smoke unscathed. As Kononji reaches to hit Aizen, Rangiku arrives. Rushing in, Gin says he'll take care of her and takes Rangiku away as Aizen says Gin is an interesting child. Catching up with Tatsuki, Keigo, and Mizuiru Kojima, Aizen's about to kill them when Zenosuke Kuramadani shows up and uses his Shikai's special ability to trap Aizen under rubble, though he breaks free. As the humans and Zenosuke run away, Gin returns, prompting Aizen to ask him what happened to Rangiku. When Gin claims he killed Rangiku, Aizen admits he's surprised because he thought Gin had feelings for her. Likening himself to a snake, Gin says he has no feelings. When Gin asks Aizen about his plans, Aizen reveals them. Stating this is good, Gin places his hand on the blade of Kyoka Suigetsu. Revealing the true ability of his Bankai, Gin places his hand up to Aizen's chest and activates Korose Kamishine no Yari. As Aizen curses him, Gin watches as Aizen's chest begins to dissolve from the inside out, leaving a gaping hole with the Hogyoku floating in the middle. As Aizen's body continues to erode, Gin runs off with the Hogyoku, leaving a slowly dissolving Aizen to fall to the ground. Uttering Gin's name, Aizen yells in rage as a pillar of light surrounds him. As the pillar of light splits to reveal Aizen's new winged form, the Hogyoku in Gin's hand disappears and rejoins Aizen, who tells Gin the Hogyoku is under his control, whether it's in his body or not. Appearing behind Gin, Aizen cuts him deeply with one swing of his sword and throws him through a building. Arriving at the scene, Rangiku goes to Gin's side. Closing in on them, Aizen is interrupted by the sudden arrival of Ichigo. As Aizen says he's disappointed Ichigo hasn't evolved, Ichigo states he wishes to move their fight away from his friends. Grabbing Aizen, Ichigo brings him outside Karakura Town. Throwing him into the ground, Ichigo tells a stunned Aizen he'll finish the fight in an instant. As he and Ichigo clash, leveling a nearby mountain, Aizen notes he and Ichigo have both reached the peak of their evolutions. Noting he understands the dimensions of Ichigo's evolution and his own are very different, Aizen states he can bring himself to crush Ichigo's sword with a single blow. When Aizen attacks, Ichigo stops it with his bare hand. Expressing surprise, Aizen tells Ichigo not to get excited. Aizen uses a full incantation of Hado No. 90, Kurohitsuki. As Aizen gloats at the full power of his Kido, Ichigo destroys it and tells Aizen he's stronger as he attacks. As Aizen moves away in a flash of light, Ichigo taunts him. When the diamond on Aizen's head opens up, he transforms once more. Firing an energy blast which damages Ichigo's left arm, Aizen uses a circular blast which surrounds his body, but Ichigo destroys it with a wave of his sword. As a shocked Aizen looks on, Ichigo tells him he'll end the fight with Saigo no Getsuga Tensho. As Aizen looks on in wonder at the new form Ichigo's taking, Ichigo explains what Saigo no Getsuga Tensho is and its costs. Amazed at how he still feels absolutely nothing from Ichigo despite this new transformation, Aizen theorizes Ichigo may have surpassed him. As an enraged Aizen proclaims such a thing is impossible, Ichigo uses Mugetsu, enveloping the battlefield in darkness. Ichigo's attack envelops Aizen and severely wounds him. After Aizen crashes into the ground, the Hōgyoku regenerates his wounds. As Ichigo moves to finish Aizen, his powers begin to fade. When Kyoka Suigetsu begins to fade as well, Aizen tries to finish off Ichigo, but an energy spike emerges from his chest before he can do so. Arriving, Urahara takes responsibility for the attack and reveals he fired a Kido into Aizen's body on the back of another Kido before Aizen achieved complete transformation. When Urahara explains it's a seal because he believed Aizen wouldn't be able to be killed, more spikes of energy emerge from Aizen's chest. Proclaiming he hates Urahara, Aizen demands to know why someone of Urahara's intellect allows himself to be controlled by that thing. Realizing Aizen is referring to the Soul King, Urahara notes Aizen has seen it and tells Aizen Soul Society would be rent asunder without the Soul King's existence. Proclaiming victors must always speak of the way the world should be and not the way it is, Aizen is sealed within Urahara's Kido. 10 days later, Aizen sits bound to a chair by many black bands, where he's standing trial under the authority of the judges of the Central 46 for high treason and a list of many other crimes. When they sentence him to 18,800 years in Muken, the 8th and lowest level of the underground prison, Aizen states it's comical to receive judgment from the likes of them. Silencing him, a judge calls him a traitor and warns him to not get cocky just because he's immortal. Ordering Aizen's eye and mouth bound at once, the judge raises his sentence up to 20,000 years. The Thousand-Year Blood War Arc. During the Wanden Reich's invasion of Soul Society, Yu Habaha reveals Aizen was being held underneath the 1st Division, where he offered him a position in their army as a special war power, only to be refused by the prisoner. Subsequently, Yu Habaha discovers he lost track of time during his meeting with Aizen. Later, after the death of the Soul King, Kyoraku visits Aizen in his underground prison and asks Aizen to respond to him. Upon hearing no response, Kyoraku then begins using keys that can unlock his seals, noting that he can only use up to 3 of them. And he starts by unlocking the seal over his mouth. After unlocking the seal over Aizen's mouth, Kyoraku states that most people who have had their mouths sealed for 2 years wouldn't be able to talk right away, but it wouldn't be the same case for Aizen. Aizen verbally agrees with Kyoraku and proceeds to walk towards him. Kyoraku is shocked to find Aizen removing other seals on his own, despite the one over his mouth being the only one unlocked. And Aizen notes that he still has 2 keys left to use. When Shunsui unlocks his left eye and ankles, Aizen notes he hasn't changed at all, which Shunsui decides to take as a compliment. Aizen states he never asked Shunsui to free him and asks him why he came down here with keys if he had no intention of doing this, prompting Shunsui to reveal he had to store the keys within his own body and could only use 3 of them. Hearing this, Aizen realizes that Central 46 predicted he would attempt to take the keys by killing Shunsui, which would trap him in Muken forever. As Shunsui asks Aizen to get in the seat behind him so that they can go to the surface, an attendant attempts to bind Aizen once more, only to have his hands partially destroyed by Aizen's Reiatsu. Aizen explains how the bindings only limits his Reiatsu's range instead of sealing it completely before asking Shunsui if he intends to have Aizen lend his power to the Gotei 13. When Shunsui states they are simply in the same predicament, Aizen wonders what kind of fresh air he could breathe if Yu Habaha is already done with Soul Society. Soon after, as black creatures begin pouring into the Seirete, Aizen is brought to the surface and the other Shinigami notice his presence as Reiatsu begins crushing the creatures. Aizen mocks the Shinigami for trying to destroy the creatures with their Zanpakuto before instructing them to crush them with Reiatsu as he's doing. Upon seeing the shocked faces of Rukia and Renji, Aizen mockingly greets them and congratulates Rukia for being promoted to the role of lieutenant within the 13th Division, suggesting it was good that her abilities were finally being recognized. When Rukia becomes enraged about his presence, he calmly reveals that Kyoraku had released him. When the argument between the other members of the Gotei 13 subsides, Aizen politely asks Kyoraku to undo the seals binding him to the chair, but Kyoraku insists that he can't do that, which causes Aizen to query why he won't. When Kyoraku reminds him that he's only permitted to remove 3 of Aizen's seals, the former captain sighs, commenting that he's expected to stop Yu Habaha from a chair, suggesting he won't have the power to do this while restrained. Kyoraku asserts that he knows Aizen can do something about the monsters attacking, and in response, Aizen uses Hado number 90, Kurohitsuki, in a devastating blast that causes the other Shinigami to flee suddenly into the laboratory. When the dust from the destruction settles, Aizen reveals that he's surprised that the chair he's bound to was able to survive the blast intact. He decides to bring down the Soul King Palace by using his Reiatsu to widen the cracks caused by his blast. Aizen gathers a dense amount of Reiatsu around himself and shoots it towards the Soul King Palace, panicking many of the Shinigami, but the attack dissipates randomly about him. Hyoraku reveals that the chair was created to cap his Reiatsu. Mayuri comes forward, revealing that he created the chair and other technologies like it in order to keep criminals who currently can't be killed in check. He shows Aizen the object that he uses to control the chair, mocking him for thinking he could defeat the chair specifically designed to keep his power in check. Upon learning that the researcher is in control, Aizen challenges Mayuri in pitting his technology against Aizen's power to see which would win. However, Aizen is soon interrupted by the arrival of Nanana Nayakup, who uses his ability to attack Aizen but is soon shocked that the bound prisoner doesn't even pass out from the attack despite being an easy stationary target. 5 minutes later, Aizen recovers and converses with Shunsui about the Stern Ritter helping the Shinigami access the Soul King Palace. Upon realizing that those who stopped him are going to get to the palace before he can, Aizen notes Ichigo is a man who is hard to forgive. Having been left behind in Seirete by the Gotei 13, Aizen watches with interest as fragments of the Lilibato rain down from the Soul King Palace while wondering what's going on up there. Much later, Yowatcher Yuhu Baha goes back to Soul Society and Aizen welcomes him to his Soul Society. Yuhu Baha destroys Aizen's chair, releasing him of his bindings, and Aizen remarks on the amount of trouble Ichigo gave Yuhu Baha in combat up in the Soul King Palace. Yuhu Baha replies that Aizen was the one who was defeated by Ichigo, and Aizen thanks him for freeing him from his chair, as he now has the means to stop the Quincy Emperor. Yuhu Baha questions why it would be in Aizen's interest to defend Soul Society, and Aizen replies that this has nothing to do with interests, but is only him repelling those who would try to rule over and control him. Their conversation is then suddenly interrupted as Ichigo and Renji Abarai attack Yuhu Baha from behind. After Yuhu Baha begins attacking Ichigo, Aizen attacks him while disguised as Renji with his Bankai active, only for Yuhu Baha to sever his left arm while deciding to crush him with his own hands. Returning to his normal form with his Zanpakuto intact, Aizen seemingly protects Renji from Yuhu Baha, who ridicules him for this, before using Hado number 99, Goryu Tenmetsu, which ruptures the ground around them and forms a large energy dragon in the air above as he rushes forward. Despite this, Yuhu Baha merely points out that Aizen's sword is cracked before sending him hurtling back with an energy blast. When Aizen, disguised as Ichigo, appears behind him with Tensa Zangetsu, Yuhu Baha stops his blade before pointing out how even Kyoka Suigetsu is useless before his power. After seemingly shattering Tensa Zangetsu and blowing a hole in Ichigo's torso, Yuhu Baha prepares to destroy Soul Society. However, Aizen, having been impaled by Yuhu Baha's hand, merely notes that Yuhu Baha's vision of Ichigo attacking him is interesting as the real Ichigo impales and attacks Yuhu Baha. As Yuhu Baha collapses into a puddle of darkness, Aizen commends Ichigo for adapting to his use of illusions so easily, and explains how he had successfully used the power of Kyoka Suigetsu against the Almighty before noting that Ichigo was the final part of his plan due to the illusions not affecting him. Admitting that he never thought Ichigo's lack of exposure to a Shikai would benefit him like this, Aizen is caught off guard when Yuhu Baha's darkness suddenly erupts and engulfs him. Ichigo defeats Yuhu Baha soon afterward, and Aizen is later imprisoned again and bound in another chair. 10 years later, Aizen senses that the last remnants of Yuhu Baha's Reiatsu have disappeared. He recalls Yuhu Baha's final words about how his defeat meant the continuation of death and the fear accompanying it, but reflects that in such a world, people would never have the hope and courage that kept death at bay. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Amagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.